angel of the Lord, what time is Mary?
And she conceived by the Holy Spirit.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death.
Behold the handmaid of the Lord.
Be it unto me according to your word.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death.
And the Word was made flesh.
And dwelt among us.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death.
Pray for us, O Holy Mother of God.
That we may be made worthy of the promises of Christ.
We beseech you, O Lord, for your grace into our hearts, that as we have known the incarnation of your Son, Jesus Christ, by the message of an angel, so by his cross and passion, we may be brought to the glory of his resurrection, through the same Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
Lord, open our hearts.
Let our Master proclaim your praise.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen. The Lord is full of compassion and mercy. Come, let us adore him. Come, let us sing to the Lord. Let us shout for joy to the rock of our salvation. Let us come before his presence with thanksgiving, and raise a loud shout to him with songs. For the Lord is a great God, and a great King above all gods. In his hand are the caverns of the earth, and the heights of the hills are his also. The sea is his, for he made it, and his hands have molded the dry land. Come, let us bow down and bend the knee, and kneel before the Lord our Maker, for he is our God, and we are the people of his pasture, and the sheep of his hand. Oh, that today you would hearken to his voice. The Lord is full of compassion and mercy. Come, let us serve. Psalm 101 and 109. I will sing of mercy and justice. To you, O Lord, will I sing praises.
I will strive to follow a blameless course. O when will you come to me? I will walk with sincerity of heart within my house.
I will set no worthless thing before my eyes. I hate the doers of evil deeds, they shall not remain with me.
A crooked heart shall be far from me. I will not know evil.
Those who in secret slander their neighbors I will destroy. Those of a haughty look and a proud heart I cannot abide.
My eyes are upon the faithful in the land, that they may dwell with me. And only those who lead a blameless life shall be my servants.
Those who act deceitfully shall not dwell in my house. And those who tell lies shall not continue in my sight.
I will soon destroy all the wicked of the land, that I may root out all evildoers from the city of the Lord.
Hold not your tongue, O God, of my praise. For the mouth of the wicked, the mouth of the deceitful is opened against me.
They speak to me with a lying tongue. They encompass me with hateful words and bite against me without a cause.
Despite my love, they accuse me. But as for me, I pray for them.
They repay evil for good and hatred for my love.
Set a wicked man against him, and let an accuser stand at his right hand.
When he is judged, let him be found guilty, and let his appeal be in vain.
Let his days be few, and let another take his office.
Let his children be fatherless, and his wife become a widow.
Let his children be waifs and beggars. Let them be driven from the ruins of their homes.
Let the creditor seize everything he has. Let strangers plunder his gains.
Let there be no one to show him kindness, and none to pity his fatherless children.
Let his descendants be destroyed,
fathers be remembered before the Lord, and his mother's sin not to be blotted out.
Let their sin be always before the Lord. But let him root out their names from the earth.
Because he did not remember to show mercy, but persecuted the poor and needy and sought to kill the brokenhearted.
He loved cursing, let it come upon him. He took no delight in blessing, let it depart from him.
He put on cursing like a garment. Let it soak into his body like water and into his bones like oil.
Let it be to him like the cloak with which he wraps around himself, and like the belt that he wears continually.
Let this be the recompense from the Lord to my accusers, and to those who speak evil against me.
But you, O Lord, my God, O deal with me according to your name. For your tender mercy's sake, deliver me.
For I am poor and needy, and my heart is wounded within me.
I have faded away like a shadow when it lengthens. I am shaken off like a locust.
My knees are weak through fasting. And my flesh is wasted and gaunt.
I have become a reproach to them. They see and shake their heads.
Help me, O Lord my God. Save me for your mercy's sake.
Let them know that this is your hand, that you, O Lord, have done it.
They may curse, but you will bless. Let those who rise up against me be put to shame, and your servant will rejoice.
Let my accusers be clothed with disgrace, and wrap themselves in their shame as in a cloak.
I will give great thanks to the Lord with my mouth. In the midst of the multitude, will I praise him.
Because he stands at the right hand of the needy, to save his life from those who would condemn him.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever.
A reading from the book of Genesis. Realizing that their father was dead, Joseph's brothers said, "What if Joseph still bears a grudge against us and pays us back in full for all the wrong that we did to him?" So they approached Joseph, saying, "Your father gave this instruction before he died. Say to Joseph, I beg you, forgive the crime of your brothers and the wrong they did in harming you. Now, therefore, please forgive the crime of the servant of the God of your father." Joseph wept when they spoke to him. Then his brothers also wept, fell down before him, and said, "We are here as your slaves." But Joseph said to them, "Do not be afraid. Am I in the place of God? Even though you intended to do harm to me, God intended it for good, in order to preserve a numerous people, as he is doing today. So have no fear. I myself will provide for you and your little ones." In this way, he reassured them, speaking kindly to them. So Joseph remained in Egypt, he and his father's household, and Joseph lived 110 years. Joseph saw Ephraim's children of the third generation. The children of Machir, son of Manasseh, were also born on Joseph's knees. Then Joseph said to his brothers, "I am about to die, but God will surely come to you and bring you up out of this land, to the land that he swore to Abraham, to Isaac, and to Jacob." So Joseph made the Israelites swear, saying, "When God comes to you, you shall carry my bones from here." And Joseph died, being 110 years old. He was embalmed and placed in a coffin in Egypt. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Third song of Isaiah. Arise, shine, for your light has come, and the glory of the Lord has dawned upon you.
reading from the Gospel according to Mark. The Pharisees came and began to argue with Jesus, asking him for a sign from heaven to test him. And he sighed deeply in his spirit and said, "Why does this generation ask for a sign? Truly I tell you, no sign will be given to this generation." And he left them, and getting into the boat again, he went across to the other side. Now the disciples had forgotten to bring any bread, and they had only one loaf with them in the boat. And he cautioned them, saying, "Watch out, beware of the yeast of the Pharisees and the yeast of Herod." They said to one another, "It is because we have no bread." And becoming aware of it, Jesus said to them, "Why are you talking about having no bread? Do you still not perceive or understand? Are your hearts hardened? Do you have eyes and fail to see? Do you have ears and fail to hear? And do you not remember when I broke the 5 loaves for the 5,000, how many baskets full of broken pieces did you collect?" They said to him, 12. "And the 7 for the 4,000, how many baskets full of broken pieces did you collect?" And they said to him, 7. Then he said to them, "Do you not yet understand?" They came to Bethsaida. Some people brought a blind man to him and begged him to touch him. He took the blind man by the hand and led him out of the village. And when he had put saliva on his eyes and laid his hands on him, he asked him, "Can you see anything?" And the man looked up and said, "I could see people, but they look like trees walking." Then Jesus laid his hands on his eyes again, and he looked intently, and his sight was restored, and he saw everything clearly. Then he sent him away to his home, saying, "Do not even go into the village." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. A song of penitence. O Lord and ruler of the host of heaven, God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, and of all their righteous offspring, you made the heavens and the earth with all their vast array. All things quake with fear at your presence, they tremble because of your power. But your merciful promise is beyond all limit. It surpasses all that our minds can fathom. O Lord, you are full of compassion, long-suffering and abounding in mercy. You hold back your hand, and do not punish as we deserve.
In your great goodness, Lord,
you have promised forgiveness to sinners, that they may repent of their sin and be saved. And now, O Lord, I bend the knee of my heart, and make my appeal sure of your gracious goodness. I have sinned, O Lord, I have sinned, and I know my wickedness only too well. Therefore I make this prayer to you. Forgive me, Lord, forgive me. Do not let me perish in my sin, nor condemn me to the depths of the earth. For you, O Lord, are the God of those who repent, and in me you will show forth your goodness. Unworthy as I am, you will save me, in accordance with your great mercy.
And I will praise you
without ceasing all the days of my life. For all the powers of heaven sing your praises, and yours is the glory to ages of ages. Amen. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth.
I believe in
Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins,
the
resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray. Our Father
in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread.
Forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time of trial, and deliver us from evil.
For the kingdom,
the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Save your people, Lord, and bless your inheritance.
Govern and uphold them now and always.
Day by day we bless you.
We praise your name forever.
Lord, keep us from all sin today,
Have mercy on us, Lord, have mercy.
Lord, show us your love and mercy.
For we put our trust in you.
In you, Lord, is our hope.
And we shall never hope in vain.
Gracious Father, whose blessed Son, Jesus Christ, came down from heaven to be the true bread that gives life to the world, evermore give us this bread, that he may live in us and we in him, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen.
Almighty and everlasting God, you hate nothing you have made and forgive the sins of all who are penitent. Create and make in us new and contrite hearts, that we, worthily lamenting our sins and acknowledging our wretchedness, may obtain of you, the God of all mercy, perfect remission and forgiveness. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
O God, almighty and everlasting Father, you have brought us in safety to this new day. Preserve us with your mighty power, that we may not fall into sin, nor be overcome by adversity. And in all we do this day, direct us in the fulfilling of your purpose, through Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
Heavenly Father, in you we live and move and have our being. We humbly pray you so to guide and govern us by your Holy Spirit, that in all the cares and occupations of our life, we may not forget you, but may remember that we are ever walking in your sight. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
Let us bless the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit, be with us all.